Okay, Professor Diaz, we premise this interview on food security, which is the thrust of the Marcos administration to make sure agriculture is back on its feet as a lucrative and a flourishing sector in Philippine society. We are aware or cognizant of the fact that a lot of research in terms of genomic research can help in that initiative. Please tell us more about this.
Yes, genomics would actually help us, as I mentioned, I think earlier, understand the very nature of the organisms. So let's say, for example, you have the crops, the livestock, the forest trees, the fishes. If you know more about these organisms in terms of their potentials based on what they possess in their DNA, then you can use those information to improve, let's say, for crops. At the end of the day, we always wanted to increase productivity.
Right.
And let's say, for example, we wanted to increase the yield of a certain crop or the characteristic of a certain livestock. Then we can do that if we know the basic information regarding its potential, regarding its regarding whether it really has that characteristic that would allow us to increase their value or their yield or product.
Okay, has there been progress in that respect? Because we've come across a lot of situations in the past where rice production has gone down because perhaps the rice strains that we plant are not resistant to flooding.
Yes.
It is not climate change proof. And a host of other problems. Pests continuously hound our rice fields in the provinces. So what advances, perhaps, from research have you encountered that can contribute or at least alleviate that problem?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for rice at least, they actually discovered, I think several years ago, they discovered one of the genes that is responsible for the ability of the rice to grow in flooded areas.
Okay.
So if you know whether a particular variety possesses that characteristic, then you can further improve that variety.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they already release
a variety. All of these advances are now available to our farmers?
The sub one variety, the one that I mentioned, I think, yeah, they are already available to the farmers. But a lot of them are available in some countries where flooding is really, really much more than what we have.
Right. Do you ever see the day that we regain our former glory in the Philippines? Because it used to be that a lot of our neighboring Asian countries would come to the Philippines to learn about rice production.
Yes.
And now we are buying from them. We are importing from countries like Vietnam or Thailand. Will we ever see the day that we regain the lead? What do you think?
It is, I think, also our hope that we will regain the lead. Right now, the trend in research or even in crop improvement is you also need what we call the molecular biology tools or the genomics tools. And a lot of people now in the Philippines are also trying to look into genomics. In fact, there are degree programs that, let's say, for example, the Agricultural Biotechnology Program, they would or that would include genomics. And it is our hope that with more and more students coming into the programs, they are more exposed to the advantages of using science and technology in crop improvement, in livestock improvement. So we do hope that time would come that we will again regain that lead.
And of course, the genome research is a big help to that. It can boost that initiative of giving our agriculturists more capability and more technology in terms of determining and using genomics in their planting. Lastly, with that partnership with South Korea, where are we now? What's in the pipeline?
We just had the signing of the records of discussion last Friday. We are already we have already done some groundwork prior to the signing.
Okay.
We have already chosen the students who would study in Korea. We have established some connections with the experts. And the building, hopefully, would soon rise. Maybe.
Do you have a timeline for that? Next year? Is that going to be a couple
of
years? I
think so. Yeah, probably it will be, the construction will probably happen next year, if not late this year. Okay. And hopefully it will be finished in 2 years' time.
Lastly, if the public, if our viewers are interested to learn more about genomics in relation to agriculture, is there a website they can visit or perhaps other reading materials and resources they can access?
I mentioned earlier that PGC Agriculture is part of the PGC in UP or of UP. There's a website for PGC, and actually now, since there are lots of available information, one can just type agricultural genomics, and I'm very sure there would be hundreds or even thousands of references that they can look at.
All right, search on the internet. That is Professor Maria Genaline Diaz, co-chair UPLB Technical Working Group for the COICA project, that is the partnership between South Korea and the Philippines. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you, Stanley.
And have a good day.
Have a good day, too.